Hi, I'm Micah, and I'm a product manager on the IoT Edge team. Allow me to demonstrate just a few of the things that are now possible with the integration that we've done to Azure Monitor. This integration is based on a set of built-in metrics that we provide out of the box, a new collector module, and a set of curated visualizations that are available by default. Now, to give you an example of how Azure Monitor allows you to manage your fleet, I'd like to show you how you can use alerts to respond to anomalies. A new application was recently deployed to one of my IoT Edge devices. It filters the messages from a temperature sensor before they're forwarded upstream to IoT Hub. I already had in place a number of alerts to tell me when something goes wrong, and one of those alerts checks for a high queue length in the Edge Hub component. The check for this alert watches to see if any of the message queues that the Edge Hub maintains have grown beyond what I've considered an acceptable threshold. Now, earlier today, I received this email alert indicating that one of my devices encountered this high queue length condition. Let's take a look at the affected resource and see what's going on. Under the monitoring section, I'll find a set of default workbooks for my IoT Edge devices. These present some curated visualizations that I can use. Let's start with the alerts view. In this view, I can see all of the alerts that are active across all of my IoT hubs. And right now there's just the one. I can quickly see that on this Edge 01 device, I've hit this high queue length condition. And clicking on the device name is going to take me to a details view. In this view, I immediately see that the problem is with my filter function. It has the queue length that is growing. So if I select it, I can even see that over time, that's what appears to be happening. If we look at the sender, we can also get a sense of how the messages are flowing from the sender to the runtime in blue, and from the runtime to the parent receiver, the filter function in orange, where it doesn't seem to be receiving and processing those messages. At this point, let's troubleshoot and look at the logs. In this view, we can pull the logs directly from one of the modules running on the device to see what's happening. Now, let's check the filter function. Right away, it looks like there's a stack trace of an exception that's being thrown in the code for that module. And that most likely explains what's going on and why the messages aren't being processed. And at this point, I really need to go talk to the developer and figure out what's going on. And while this has been useful for drilling in and troubleshooting a single device, what if I want to get a sense of the health for all of my devices on my IoT hub? For that, we have the fleet view. In this fleet view, we get a summary for the past 2 hours by default of the devices that are in my fleet. Now, this is just the current IoT hub, but if I have other IoT hubs, I can include those as well. I can drill into the list of devices, get a snapshot for the health of a given device. And if I need to, I can jump back to that detailed view that we saw earlier. In closing, what I've shown is available out of the box, but it can also be extended or customized to suit your particular needs. And we believe that this integration with Azure Monitor will help you get more out of your IoT Edge devices and make troubleshooting and monitoring that much easier. Thanks.